Hello everybody, my name is Sirhc and welcome back to Underground, my single player Let's Play series. I've been doing some work off camera since the last episode, and one of the things I did was I kind of finished up this farm area. I got the ceiling all done finally, and I got the stone out of there, put red mushrooms all on the ceiling, I put red mushrooms behind these fences here, so we just have like the roof here. And the wall there, but everything else is all covered up. I covered this up all nice and pretty. Looks good. I like it. Very polished up. Looks very nice. I've been doing some other stuff as well, mainly over in this area. I got this all polished up too, and I haven't moved what we have over here. We have this thing, our furnace setup where we smelt things. I built this a long time ago. I think it was still when I was doing the old theme, which I didn't really have a theme yet. And so I built this. I wanted to have like stone and nether brick because this is a furnace area. And I thought that made sense to have kind of, you know, stone, non-flammable stuff. But now we're going for this theme with all the logs and the wood, and so I also realized that we have space down here that I wasn't really going to use for anything else. We used to have a staircase over here that went down to the lava level, but I didn't have any plans to go down there, and there was a lot of other stuff like with the farms and stuff that kind of got in the way over there. So I decided to just block this off. Move our furnace over here, our charcoal generator, just some chests for all of our coal and coal blocks. And then over here, we have our wonderful furnace smelter. And I got some nice red mushroom blocks in there to kind of add some nice color when you look in there, which is kind of cool. And I got everything all covered up. There's a little bit of redstone you can see, but not a lot. I was able to cover most of it up. And it looks pretty nice. I like it. I like it a lot. Yeah, looks pretty cool. What else did we do? I think that was mostly it. The other thing would be over at the subscriber hall. Still haven't added more names. I need to get on that, but I've been trying to work on finishing up the areas that we have done with the names that I have put there already. Trying to get that a little bit more finished up, and let's go down here. But I went ahead with the whole mineshaft idea that I brought up at the end of last episode. And so I took out a couple of these supports. So now we have them like at every other one. And then I put a ladder here. And we have a nice little walkway going up here. And then from here we can, you know, this is at level 11. And from here we can dig through and we can maybe start here, dig through and do every three blocks like I normally do, and just create a bunch of mine shafts up here that we can mine through. I like it. It works out pretty nicely. I haven't done a lot of this stuff, but I have filled in a little bit more of the things. The big problem with this thing is it's so far away from my storage room and the rest of my base, and I need a lot of resources, and so there's a lot of like running back and forth to get stuff. But today what I want to work on is I want to get the village maybe not really done, but I want to get it a lot farther. Mainly I want to get it all blocked off and lit up, and maybe get a few more houses built so that we can actually get our villagers running around, and maybe we can get some more villagers hanging out here. Because right now there's still some dark spots. We have some zombies. I think there's a zombie over here. Yep. Hey, guy. So I want to make sure that everything is lit up properly. And make sure that all the cave entrances like that and over there. And there's an entrance back there. Get all those blocked off with some wooden fences. And maybe get some other houses built. Maybe put one in this corner. Not sure exactly where all we want to do something. We need something in this open area. And I think I was thinking about doing a house But what happened here? Oh yeah, I think I had a creeper explosion a while back. I think I might want just some sort of like courtyard up here or something. Maybe a fountain. That'd be kind of cool. But like we have some room maybe in this corner. We have some room in that corner for a house. I guess we really can't squeeze too many more houses around here. We are pretty full. I guess it depends on how cluttered I want it to be. And if I want to actually have houses here in the middle. Which I don't want too much there. I mean, the houses, they don't really do much. They're just here for aesthetics. So if we could just line the walls with houses and then do some nice courtyard stuff or just some decorative stuff in the middle, that'd be kind of cool. But I'm going to get started on cleaning this place up, and I'll be back. I've been working on this place for a little bit now, and I got everything all blocked off, all covered up. Made a little porch stand thing here with fences all around it so that we have maximum security. Got to protect these villagers from the dangers of the outside world, of the caves. I got a little blocked off there. Made a house over here. Nice little two-story house. The only two-story house we have. I have planned on making like a couple of two stories, but I haven't actually done anything yet. So this is the only one. I don't know if we really have room for any more. We don't have a lot of open space, and we have like that side over there. That's about it. but I also made entrance to the slime thing. I gotta make a tunnel here. I need to finally clean this up eventually. Eventually we'll get onto that. Make a little tunnel to that and a little room where the slime collection happens. And then I made another house up here with a couple entrances on either side. Ooh, fancy. Fancy. Still don't have any interiors done yet, but at least I have some nice little facades for the houses. Went around and checked all the lighting, and I think everything is lit up nicely. I got torches in the houses right now, just kind of as a temporary lighting. Eventually, I'll probably switch those out, or at least put the torches, you know, in better spots than just sitting on the floor and such. Yeah, like I said, we got this little porch thing out here with some fences around it. That needs to get switched out to wood. How hard will that be? We might need to break this. Let's switch that out real quick. Boom. Done. Fantastic. Got those caves blocked off. Very good. I put some mushrooms around. I hoed up some land because we need some land for the farmers to keep busy harvesting. I made a little pen for Gerald here, our chicken that we found. And yeah, that's about it right now. There's still a lot of work to do in here, but at least it's a little bit better, and we have everything blocked off, and we have the light done. We have the lighting, or not done, but we have it all lit up. I know one thing that I really want to add is some sort of water feature. I'm thinking, I was trying to think of where to make it come from. At first I thought maybe come from like over here by this cave, have a river go through here. I know I want it to fall off here, have a little waterfall, and a little pond right at the bottom of here by this house. But I don't know if I really want a river going all the way through here. That'd take up a lot of space. Maybe. I mean, it wouldn't be terrible just to have a nice little river, have maybe a couple bridges going across. I also thought of maybe having it come down through here, but then we have this house that is like right on the edge, so that might cause a little problem. We'd have to have it kind of skinny here as we have that entrance there. Or I could change up this house a bit. The other idea I had was to have just water falling like right about here, have water fall from the ceiling, maybe somewhere like in the middle of here, just water fall kind of through the ceiling, have it sort of blocked off so we don't have villagers kind of swimming in it. As best as we could, at least have it blocked off. I guess I'm not sure exactly how well we could do that. But yeah, and then just have it flow over here and then fall down. It'd be kind of cool, I think. Yeah, pretty cool. So, I guess next move that we can do is we can finally let these guys out. Hey, how's it going? You guys can get out. You guys can go stretch your legs, run around. Go do what you love. Just running around and opening doors. Go ahead. Come on, guys. Are you a farmer? You are a farmer. Ooh, we still have a farmer. That's good. And you sell axes. Yes, very good axes. And you are useless because we don't have raw pork chops or raw chicken. Come on, guys. Go, run around. What are you guys doing here? I'm quite perplexed by the fact that they're just sitting here. I haven't checked the lighting over here. We do have a torch there. It'd be nice to just kind of continue the grid, but it looks like that. Oh yeah, we could do that. Continue the grid right here. 570 and 1020. I know I've said this before, but yeah, whenever I do like jack-o'-lanterns in the ground as lighting, I always do like on any of them that end in 5 for coordinates, and then if they end in 0 for coordinates. And that's where both the X and Z directions. And that makes it so that the light never dips below 8 or 9. Yeah, it looks like it's 9 throughout all the center there. So that's pretty good. So now the light should be pretty good around here. I saw an 8, but that's okay. I just don't want 7. And the lighting should be good in there. We really should kind of block off some of that, but that's okay. But yeah, cool. We have villagers in here. So now that we have villagers in here, and we have a village and people wandering around, did someone go over here? I thought I saw someone. I wonder if the farmer, you know, the farmer should still have crops in his inventory from before. So really, he should go and plant those fields automatically. Otherwise, I can just go and grab some stuff and plant them. Where did our farmer go? This place is so big. Oh, there you are. Hey, guy. Yeah, you should go plant the crops. That'd be a good thing for you to do. I don't feel like doing it, really. Anyways, now that we actually have a village open again, it's open for business, and we have villagers running around. I want to go over to our villager curing place. I suppose I'll have to go make some weakness potions and get some golden apples. And then we'll head over there and get some villagers made so we can fill up our village a little bit more. I realized that I accidentally ate all my apples recently. I had a big stockpile, but there's creatures. Yeah, let's get out of here. Okay. I'm always afraid of that. I need to do something about that portal and creatures getting into there. Get out of here, jerk. Jerk face. There we go. There's a creeper and a zombie. Get out of here. Where's this creeper? There's a ghast somewhere. Where did this... Did the creeper go back through? Oh, that's not good. I want to take care of that guy. Dang it. Oh, we have the other nether portal off. Get out of here. Okay, we did it. Oh, man. Which reminds me, I should probably turn that on before we head in there. So that when we send them back, they will end up in this one. There we go. Fantastic. Anyways, as I was saying, yes, I kind of ran out of fish and ran out of food. And so apples were one thing that I had on hand, and I ate them all. And that is a bad decision, bad choice, because then I didn't have any apples for making these golden apples. So let's head over back to the zombie villager curing place. I don't have a good and fancy name. I probably should have a fancy name for that. It is a wonderful place. Fantastic place. Let's see. I don't have any blocks. That is a bad choice. I kind of want to block that off because the villagers are going to end up coming in here. Probably be good to block that off as well. I probably have blocks somewhere in here. Or I can get blocks at least. I can just get some of these. That'll work. Definitely need to clean this place up and figure out how to get this thing working nicely. Because if you remember, when we come out of here, we just send the villagers through. And so they're kind of just wandering around in here until we pick them up with minecarts, which hopefully I have minecarts. That is not something I checked. Dang it, I am woefully unprepared. There should be minecarts stacked up in the system. Is that a minecart there? Why is there a minecart there? Okay, let's check this place. What do we got going on? They are all on. We don't want that. We want all those off. Okay. Let's just run through here. Get back here. This thing, actually, let's break that. Did I pick it up? Yes, I did. We need minecarts in here. Okay, I have enough. I got 7 of them in there. And now, let's wait for some zombie villagers. None in that group. Okay. I see a zombie villager right there in the back. So, we shall push the button now. And he's going to drop down. Oh, the other one. Did the baby? Yeah. Baby came in there. I don't want you. I'm sorry. You get out of there. Thank you. And push this button. And you're going to get picked up. Yes, you are. Fantastic. And then you get dropped off up here. Yes, there we go. And we block you in. Fantastic. Let's get a few more. And there we go. We got 6 new zombie villagers to convert. So let's try and splash them all with as few potions as we can. Do there and there. Is everyone converted? Or weakened, I should say. Did I eat? I ate an apple, didn't I? Oh, I hate... having apples stacked is very dangerous. Because somehow you click them. I only have... I should have only used 6 there. And I used 8. So apparently I clicked... I ate them twice. Just because if you click on them... if you have them in a stack and you click on them, you just, like, eat them all the time. I don't have it happen with, like, food or anything. Although I think apples... No, with apples, you still have to, like, eat them. Like, it still takes time, even with golden apples. So I don't know what's going on there. But yeah, that's... I usually, when I convert villagers, I make sure to put the golden apples one to a slot, just because... Otherwise, you're just going to waste them, because you'll eat them, and that is... I don't really need the absorption right now. So now we just gotta wait 5 minutes, I believe it is. It's been a while, but I'm pretty sure it's 5 minutes for these guys to convert, and then we can send them on their merry way to their new living space. Well, they all converted. I'm not sure what we have, though, because they all sunk down. Oh, I just kind of pushed them off. Whoops. That's okay. It's kind of what we have to do anyways. Let's break that. And... should I go in there right now? Possibly. I can probably send more of these guys in here. But it might be a good idea to take a few of them out. And send you on your way. Go. Just go. Okay, let's get some more. I'm just a little afraid of sending too many people out here at a time. Could probably do like 2 or 3 at a time, though. Wouldn't be too bad. Let's send you. Looks like we got a blacksmith. Or, yeah, some sort of blacksmith. Toolsmith or weaponsmith or armorer. Let's break that and send you in. And we got a cleric. Very good. I wonder, can I access this? Let's sell some of this rotten flesh right now. And, oh wow, you still have room. Very nice. Let's send you in. And we have another blacksmith of some sort. And let's head in there and make sure that we can get these guys sent off on their merry way. So, pick that guy up. Pick that guy up. Nope. Nope. Get back here. You guy. Pick that guy up and send you off. And send you off. Goodbye. Go away. Don't die, please. Please don't die. That'd be a bad idea. Alright. And we got two more to send in. Got a regular brown coat. What are you? A fisherman. Not super useful. Although we do have lots of string now. We could sell. And we have a librarian. Very good. We could buy some. I think our we used to have a librarian. I think. Unless that was at the our old villager converter that we used to have. But that librarians are very useful because I can get glass from them and I can get bookshelves, which means I can get books from them. Alright, so we got all these guys. Let's send them off on the track. Back to the portal. You go. Come on. I need to fix up this track. We gotta do a lot of work in the nether, which I think we'll have to focus on that soon. I kind of mentioned last episode that our base is coming along. We're getting a lot of stuff done that I've wanted to get done, and a lot of kind of essentials I feel like we need in the base. You know, we have a place to smelt stuff, we got tree farm, we got storage and bulk storage, and all these things that are wonderful and great. Head in, please. Thank you. Don't head back. Don't head back. Go. But yeah, our base is coming along, and it's set up very nicely. And so I think we can afford now to kind of step away from the base a bit and get to work on some things outside of the base. Like in the nether, actually getting some sort of hub built. Although I haven't quite figured exactly what I want to do in the nether, but I don't want to make like a normal hub with a bunch of tunnels. Like, I want to actually make structures in the nether. I mean, I know, like, some of my plans when I first started this series, way back when, I think I even talked about it in, like, the first series, was, like, I was kind of planning on spending a lot of time in the nether and, you know, building, like, tree farms in here and stuff, because it'd be a lot easier to actually, you know, I have a lot more open space, whereas underground I gotta dig out huge areas to get open space. So I had always planned on actually building some structures in the nether rather than just a little room with tunnels. And I still plan on doing that. Please don't send back. No. No. Can we stop him? Stop. I command you. So I don't know exactly what I want to do here around the portals, but we definitely want something interesting. Something cool. Something that would also kind of make sense in this area. We can probably just go through this portal. It should be fine. And we have everyone here. Fantastic. And we just need to do that. And he gets shot out. Fantastic. And everyone should be here. Should be around somewhere. We got Weaponsmith. Is this the old one? No, this is a new one. Ooh. Might need to have to go get some trading things, and we can see what kind of things these guys have to unlock. Looks like our farmers have been busy planting these fields, at least. I don't know if they've planted the ones up there. So we got a weaponsmith here, and I have some coal. So let's get some emeralds off of that and let you reset. And we have a cleric here. You are new. Let's get some emeralds off of that as well. Fantastic. And what do you have opened up? Nothing too good. I guess we'll buy an iron axe just to open up a new trade. Two redstone, one lapis. Not great. Not that I'd really use those, really. The only thing I'd really use a cleric for is maybe glowstone. And... that's not as good as the other one. And knock back one sword. Not too good. Sorry, weaponsmith. You are not my favorite. Two glowstone and one eye of ender. Eh, could be better. What else do we have? We got a fisherman here. I got lots of string. And I will gladly give you all my string for whatever you can give me. What else do we have here? Coal or fish to get cooked fish. Yeah, I think I'd rather just cook it. What else do we have? Eh, that is terrible. Let's give you some more string. And what else can we get from you? I have a feeling this guy's not going to give us anything good. What if I do that? I might need to maybe buy something else. I could try buying... Well, I can give him coal. I do have lots of coal. But I'd rather not spend it all on emeralds. Nah, it doesn't look like you're going to open up anything else. So that is not super useful. We got the cleric. We already checked out... Got a farmer here. I think you're the old one. But I do have lots more pumpkins for you. Hopefully you will take a lot of them, maybe. What about melons? 10 melons. Ech. You're not liking my stuff, are you? What about back here? We have some carrots. I know I do have some wheat. Not a whole lot. And most of my potatoes I've eaten. Looks like we blocked out the carrots. Are you gonna reset? Yes, you are. Fantastic. We can sell some more pumpkins. And that's it for pumpkins. And that's it for melons. And, man, farmers are fantastic. Because you can just grow all the stuff to sell them. And when they do fill up, you might have to buy like some of this stuff, but it's food, and food is always good. It's always useful. You know, I mean, not that I go around eating cakes or cookies all the time, but I certainly can if I have to buy them off a villager. But yeah, those are really nice. Butcher, you are not useful. Librarian, what do we? Ooh, silk touch book. Oh, I forgot to grab a book. Let's go get one. Weaponsmith? Oh, you're a new weaponsmith. Let's open you up. What are you gonna get me? We gotta unlock him twice. Now we have to buy an axe. Unless we want to buy a Bane of Arthropod sword, but this is cheaper. And now what are you gonna open up for your sword? And oh, come on. Ah, it's terrible. It's just terrible. Alright, we need a book. Are you the one that we unlocked already? Yes, you are. You are the mediocre one. So, we do have very limited books, but this is one thing that we can definitely use our books for, is unlocking villager trades. We just need one of them. And the librarians we can buy bookshelves off of later, which means we can get more books from breaking those without a silk touch. So let's go get the librarian. And silk touch book, that's pretty good. I will gladly buy that for $1. And... we got a bookshelf. So we got a bookshelf for 4 emeralds. It's not terrible. We can buy those. Fantastic. What else are you going to open up? What are you going to open up? We got a clock. Oh, we got glass. 5 glass. Ooh, that is pretty good, I think. I think that's pretty high. What else we have? Power 3. Not great, but not terrible. I think to unlock... more books, I'm gonna have to buy something else, like a clock. I'm gonna try doing that. Are you gonna? And knock back one. Meh. I think that's... they might open up more, but you're going to have to do a lot more trading, I think, to get any more book enchants. But yeah, that's not... the Silk Touch is really good, and the Glass Trade is really good. Who else do we have? We have a Butcher. You are useless. Anyone in here? No. They have not planted up here yet. Are you the fisherman? No, you're another butcher. Oh, we have two butchers. Fantastic. I wish what would be really nice is if they would actually be named what their profession is. That would actually be a really nice feature that I just thought of. I mean, I'm sure other people have thought of that before, but that's the first time that I have thought of that. I could potentially name tag these guys, but it would be a pain in the butt. And I think that's everyone. We got the cleric. Are you? Yeah, you're the same one. Because I think to name tag them in single player, I have to be standing inside of a nether portal to right click on them. Otherwise, they will. When you right click on them, it just trades them. I'm not sure if there's any other methods that we have. But it'd be really nice to name tag these guys, even if I just name tag them with the profession, or maybe like profession and then some sort of rating for like their trades, you know, like a weaponsmith A or weaponsmith 1 something, or weaponsmith awesome, because this guy's pretty good, and I'd like to be able to just kind of go around and, you know, see his name right above him. Like I can just look at Gerald here. Without having to click on them and then go through their trades. But that is all we're going to do today. We got this place up and lively, up and running. It's going. We're doing things. I like it. Doing some villager trading. I've been really looking forward to getting this going so that we could get some emeralds and we can buy some stuff like bookshelves and glass. I haven't had a good way of getting glass at all. Like, I think I had a librarian at our old zombie curing place, but that's really far away, and I didn't have a good way to get emeralds because I didn't have anyone to really sell things to. But now we have plenty of villagers here. Oh, and they're up on the deck. Cool. But now we have plenty of villagers here, lots of variety, and we have a good system for bringing them or curing them and bringing them here so we can get more. And as we get more, we can kind of kill off some of these worthless ones, like the butchers. I mean, I could kill him off now. He really is useless, because I can't. I don't have any raw meat. But we'll leave him here for now, just to kind of fill up the place. And also, possibly today, as this video is going out, there is a new Minecraft snapshot. If I put this up when I want to, and if Mojang puts up their snapshots when they have said that they were going to, which means we will have some new stuff. They won't apparently have all of the features that they've talked about in this first snapshot, but hopefully we can play around. Hopefully they have the end stuff. I'd have to assume that they at least have that so that people can start playing around with that. Although honestly, if they have the end stuff, then the stuff that they don't have would involve the dual wielding, and that seems kind of like a small thing. So I don't know, or maybe they have some of the end stuff and not all of it. I don't know. Who knows? We'll find out. You guys probably already know by now. Yeah, next episode we'll probably be playing around with some of that stuff. Hopefully it is the end stuff. Otherwise, I'm not going to have a lot to do playing around with dual wielding. But anyways, I hope you have enjoyed. Make sure to leave a like and a comment down below. And I will see you next time. Goodbye, peoples. Stupid butcher.